In this lecture, we will discuss about writing hyperconjugating structures. Let us discuss first case of carbocation. So take a simple carbocation CH3CH2+. This is a primary carbocation, 1 degree carbocation. Because this carbocation is attached to only one carbon. This carbon is also called alpha carbon. So a carbon adjacent to the positive charge. The hydrogen attached to the alpha carbon is called alpha hydrogen. So we have here 3 alpha hydrogens. So 3 hydrogen is attached. So we have 3 alpha hydrogen. A hydrogen that is alpha position is hyperconjugable. So hydrogen at alpha position participates in hyperconjugation. So let us say, in this case, we can basically make 3 hyperconjugating structures because we have 3 hyperconjugable hydrogen. So let us say if I break this bond A, then we will have carbon-carbon double bond. So we have carbon-carbon double bond. This bond is broken, so we will have positive charge, hydrogen. If I break this bond, I will have another hyperconjugating structure, that is I have to break this bond. So here we will have hydrogen that contains positive charge. We will have carbon-carbon double bond. Another possibility is we can break this bond, that is path C. So we can break this bond, in that case we will have hydrogen, there is a positive charge, carbon-carbon double bond. So there are 3 hyperconjugating structures are possible. So in this case we have 3 hyperconjugating structures. Now basically we can make a resonance hybrid or hyperconjugating hybrid. So let us try to make the hybrid. So if you see, in some cases we have this carbon hydrogen bond broken, but in some cases we have full carbon hydrogen bond. So in hybrid structure we will have this bond is slightly broken. Similarly, this carbon hydrogen bond in this case is slightly broken. So we will have a carbon hydrogen bond is slightly broken, similarly with other one. Now between these two carbon we have double bond, but in the actual molecule we have single bond. So we will have single bond double bond character. Here we have hydrogen, here we have hydrogen. If you see, we have a positive charge, but in these 3 molecules we does not have a positive charge. This means this carbon will have delta plus charge. Now these 3 hydrogens, so this hydrogen has a positive charge, in this case this hydrogen has a positive charge, and this hydrogen has a positive charge. So this means in hybrid this hydrogen will have some positive charge. So this is the actual molecule. Another important we can say in this case, this carbon hydrogen bond is not a perfect single bond. So if I compare the bond length, with the regular carbon hydrogen bond, if I have CH, 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 or even we can compare with CH3 here, let us say this carbon hydrogen bond length is X angstrom and this carbon hydrogen bond length is Y angstrom. So in this case, this bond will be larger or longer, this bond will be smaller. So we can say Y is greater than X. So Y angstrom is greater than X angstrom. This bond is larger. So bond strength will be smaller compared to this carbon hydrogen bond. So let us name this bond. We can say this bond as a capital A and this bond is a capital B. So we can say bond A is weaker than, bond B. Similarly, we can write hyperconjugating structures for this molecule. In this case, this carbon is alpha carbon, this carbon is alpha carbon. So we have 6 alpha hydrogen. That is, we have 6 hyperconjugable hydrogen. So in this case, we will have 6 hyperconjugating structures. Similarly, one can draw for this case. So in this case, we have 3 alpha hydrogen, 3 alpha carbon. So 3 alpha carbon we have, and we have 9 alpha hydrogen. That is, we have 9 alpha, 9 hyperconjugable hydrogen. That is, in this case, we can write 9 hyperconjugating structures. Now let us say case of alkene. Basically, we can have different kind of alkene. This alkene is a non-substituted or not a substituted alkene. If I remove one hydrogen and put an alkyl group, let us say methyl group, this alkene, because it has one substitution, this is called monosubstituted alkene. This alkene will be disubstituted. There are two possibilities for disubstitution. So this is a disubstituted alkene. Similarly, this one is also disubstituted alkene. So these two are basically disubstituted. So in case of disubstitution, we can have two alkyl group attached on the same carbon, or these two alkyl groups can be on different carbon. We can have trisubstituted. This alkene is a trisubstituted alkene. And this one is a tetrasubstituted alkene. Tetrasubstituted. Now in this case, a carbon attached adjacent to double bond, we will call this as alpha carbon. So in this case, this carbon is alpha In this case, this carbon is alpha as well as this carbon is alpha. In this case, we have 3 alpha carbon. This is alpha carbon. This is alpha carbon. And this one is alpha carbon. In this case, we have 4 alpha carbon. This one, this one. And this one is also an alpha carbon. Let us name this. This is compound 1. This is alkene 2. This is alkene 3. So there are two possibilities for alkene of type 3. This is alkene 4 and this is alkene 5. Now a hydrogen attached to the alpha hydrogen is hyperconjugable. So in this case we have 3 hyperconjugable hydrogen. In this case we have 6 hyperconjugable hydrogen. In this case we have 9 hyperconjugable hydrogen. In this case we have 12 hyperconjugable hydrogen. In case of 1, we does not have any hyperconjugable hydrogen. So this is 0 hyperconjugable hydrogen. So let us say we have 1 that is mono, not substituted. Not substituted. 2 that is mono substituted. 3 that is disubstituted. 4 is tri. And 5 is tetra. In this case we have 0 hyperconjugable hydrogen. 3, 6, 9, 12. So in this case we will have no hyperconjugating structure. None of the hyperconjugating structure. In this case we will have 3 hyperconjugating structure. Now in this case we will have 6, in this case 9, in this case 12. So let us see one case, that is for monosubstituted. So we can draw hyperconjugating structures for a monosubstituted alkene. So we can either break this bond, in that case we will have a hyperconjugating structure possible. This bond goes here and this bond goes here. So we will have, this bond is basically double bond is, so this carbon, carbon, electron cloud we will have here, hydrogen, hydrogen. Now there is a double bond CH2 and this hydrogen will be plus and this carbon will have one more hydrogen. So this is a structure. We can also break this hydrogen. So similarly if I break this hydrogen we will have another hyperconjugating structures. We will have CH2 and then we will have hydrogen plus this side hydrogen. So this is B. We can also have another possibility that we can break this hydrogen carbon bond. Let us call this as a C. So in this case we will have this carbon hydrogen double bond. Carbon carbon double bond. And then hydrogen will be plus. Here will we have electron cloud with a negative charge. So there are 3 hyperconjugating structures are possible for this alkene. Similarly we can write hyperconjugating structure for radical. So let us say if I have this radical CH2 dot, this carbon is alpha, so we have 3 hyperconjugable hydrogen. So we will have 3 hyperconjugating structures. Now writing hyperconjugating structure is easy. We have carbon hydrogen. So we can give one electron here. And this carbon hydrogen bond will give one electron here and one electron goes to the hydrogen. So we will have similarly, we can break this bond, we can break this bond. So we will have three possibilities. So this is one hyperconjugating a structure. We can have another hyperconjugating a structure. In this case, we can break this bond. So this is A, this is B. Another possibility is we can break this bond. So if I break this bond, now hydrogen. So in this case, we again have three hyperconjugating structures. So in case of radical, in case of carbocation, or in case of alkene, we can draw hyperconjugating structure. In case of toluene, so third case we have, last case, that is fourth case, that is case of toluene. So we have this molecule. In this case again we can write three hyperconjugating structures. So this carbon is alpha carbon. So one time we can break this bond, another time we can break this bond, one time we can break this bond. So if I break this bond, we have to shift this electron cloud here. So we will have in this case carbon carbon double bond, hydrogen hydrogen. Now this hydrogen will be positive and there will be electron cloud. Similarly, we can have break this hydrogen. So everything will be same. Simply I have to break this hydrogen. I will have a double bond between carbon carbon and then we have electron cloud here. Similarly, we can write another hyperconjugating structure by breaking this bond. So here we will have carbon hydrogen, hydrogen double bond, and we will have a hydrogen that will have a positive charge. So in this case we have three hyperconjugating structures. So toluene also has three hyperconjugating structures, that is possible. If you see this lecture, what we have discussed? We have discussed if you want to write hyperconjugating a structure, you have to look for alpha carbon. Look for alpha carbon. And how we look for alpha carbon? A carbon adjacent to positive charge, a carbon adjacent to double bond, or a carbon adjacent to electron, that is radical. So alpha carbon is a carbon adjacent to carbocation, or it can be radical, or it can be a double bond. So these are the three possibilities we have. And once you know the alpha carbon, you know the alpha hydrogen, and after that we can easily break this bond to get the hyperconjugating structures. So this is all about writing hyperconjugating structures.